people are pretty understanding if you say that, hey, it's going to take us some time to get our arms around the problem, but we're actively working on it. Kind of like, as an analogy, take the blowback that Joel Osteen got from how he handled Hurricane Harvey. Now, he said that the church was inaccessible and that people should try other locations and then come to his church. But then a lot of people started to call him out. Like, folks literally walked up to the church and was like, hey, this is pretty accessible. I don't know what the problem is. And then he later came out and said, well, we had a lot of water in the lower levels and we weren't sure if it was safe because the last thing we wanted is for everybody to pile into the church and then the building collapse. Well, my thing was, if he would have said that in the beginning, like, hey, we're taking on a lot of water in the lower levels and it's going to take us some time to assess the situation, I think, me personally, I would have accepted that. Like, I would have been okay with that, as opposed to just saying, oh, well, the building's inaccessible and people can clearly walk up to it. So I think just letting people know that you're getting your arms around the situation goes a long way, and it doesn't come across as a cop out. Because to your point, both with Joel Osteen as well as Mark Zuckerberg, it kind of came across like they were copping out a little bit. And that's what they got called out for.
And I think it's one of the unique things we attach to like public figures or to brands is that if you're putting yourself out there and you're sharing opinions and you're making your feelings about things known, then the public is going to call you on things. That's, you know, it's not a same thing as like a private citizen. Once you share, you know, that you should be whatever, a caring, loving, accepting person, and then a situation happens where people see you as not being a caring, loving, supportive person, you're going to get called out for that.